My name is Basim Baig. I'm a senior engineering manager here, and I manage the Duolingo English Test Security team. What I do is, it's two main things. One is we want to prevent any test takers from acquiring a score through any sort of rule breaking of malicious ways. We want to detect that, we want to prevent that. And the second thing is we want to make sure all of the user data that they have entrusted us with, we keep it safe. Because we are born digital, because our test has always been online, we pay a lot of attention to the actual administration of the test and making that application secure. A common misconception about online testing is that, is this not as secure as traditional test center-based models? That's just not true. The point of technology is to add value without taking away other things. What the Duolingo English Test does is it makes a secure testing environment possible without taking away the access of having to go to a testing center, having to potentially take a flight maybe even, spend a lot of money. And the way we kind of do that is the actual application that we've designed that you take the test on, it gathers signals about what's happening during the test, right? So we detect stuff. Then we take that, pass it through our AI and machine learning systems, bundling it and sending it to the proctors. A human always has to make the certification decision at the end. It cannot be automated. It's been designed to do that from the get-go, from the very first day. No machine will ever make a decision on the certification of the test. That is always done by a human. So think about this. Think about your favorite sport, you know. Think about a very close decision, you know, somebody's supposed to be safe or not safe. Generally, what we rely on is, you know, an umpire, referee looks at it, makes a call. Great, works 90% of the time. Sometimes you need a slow-mo, right? Sometimes you need to go really scrutinize it frame by frame. Now, what is happening? We're leveraging technology. We're looking at what happened using additional tools. But the human is still making the decision. It might be a more senior referee, it might be somebody who has more understanding of what's happening. So the way I think of technology for us in security is we're the slow-mo, right? We come in, we give you the additional signals, but the slow-mo technology doesn't automatically say whether the player is safe or not, right? The human is gonna say that, the referee is gonna say that. And the proctors at the end of the day are the referees.